Hola mi gente, it's Miss Castiano, and we are here to celebrate Hispanic Heritage Month. If you guys didn't know, I am from Bayamón, Puerto Rico, and I'm back again with another cardboard recycle art project. We are going to be creating Puerto Rican Viagante inspired masks. But first, let's get behind the history and the meaning behind these masks. Let's go! A Viagante is a common folkloric character seen in Puerto Rico during the Carnival, Santiago, Saint Day, and other festival celebrations. The tradition's origins go back to the 12th century medieval Spain. The Viagantes represent the evil Moors who Saint James defeated. On July 25th, his Saint's Day, people celebrated the victory and made Viagante characters to represent the defeated Moors. The name Viagante comes from the Spanish word for bladder, vejiga. The Viagante, a demon-like character, would inflate a dry cow's bladder, then paint it to resemble a balloon. In the 17th century, the Viagante began to represent good versus evil in Puerto Rico. They were used to mirror demons in religious festivals and parade to scare people to go back to church. The style of these masks represent a blend of African, Spanish, and Caribbean influences in Puerto Rico culture. For example, when the traditions first came to Puerto Rico with the Spanish, it was influenced by the Taínos, an excellent mask maker. And then, with the Africans who were influenced of the processions with their heavy drum music of La Bomba y La Plena. Today, the Viagante has developed into a symbol of culture identity, resilient and resistant. Different towns in Puerto Rico have variations of the character. In the southern town of Ponce, the masks are made with papier-mâché and with many curved horns and fangs. In the northern town of Luisa, the African influence is evident in the mask made from coconut shells and carved wooden horns. The Viagantes roam the streets of the town in bands, looking for people to scare with their fierce faces. They rattled their vejigas and played playfully with the people around them. They danced to African rhythms of bomba y plena, music through the streets. The Viagantes also lead the crowd in a call and response chant. Everyone knows these nonsense rhymes and sings along. A bucket list of mine is to eventually go back to Puerto Rico and witness this in person. I cannot wait. But until then, let's create our own Viagante mask. Let's go over the supplies you'll need. You're definitely going to need a ton of boxes, and if you haven't heard me talk about this before, Amazon boxes is the way to go. Their cardboard is so soft and easy for kids to cut into them, even just using regular scissors. Don't forget my Viagante mask tracers, which I provide for you on my TPT for free. Download it and just print it off on some cardstock. Link is in my bio. Hot glue guns, hot glue sticks, scissors, Sharpie, paint, paintbrushes, and some primer paint. When prepping for a project like this, you need to ask your families to help bring Amazon boxes in. Once you have collected all your boxes, go ahead and prep your cardboard by cutting it into squares and rectangles for your students. If you have any cardboard that's a nice big surface like this, use this for the heads. I keep this separate from the rest of the cardboard that will be used for the eyes, the mouth, and the horns. I also divided my cardboard into two boxes, one for the eyes and mouth and the other one for the horns. This helps with organization in the classroom. I have my tracers laid out on the table for the kids to come and pick and choose how they want their Viagante mask to look. I also give the freedom for my kids to design their own parts for their mask as well. Once students have an idea of what they want to create, go ahead and go back to your table, start tracing away and cutting your pieces out. I've said it before and I'll say it again. Amazon cardboard is so easy to cut into. I'm using regular kid scissors just to show you how easy this stuff is. Cardboard tips 101. Make sure when you place your tracers, do not place it on the center of the cardboard because that's going to take forever to cut out. And it might be difficult depending on the cardboard you have. But by placing it on the edge of the cardboard like so, not only would it be a lot easier to cut out, but also will save you a ton of time. And you can use the rest of the cardboard to cut your other pieces out as well. Now I'm going to show you how the students can design their own horns. Go ahead and get a piece of cardboard and lay out how you want that horn to be. Then essentially what you're going to do is put a bubble around that line. You can even think about how thick and thin you want that horn to be. After that, go ahead and cut it out. Now, we've talked about how Viagante masks are known to be symmetrical. So once you have this piece cut out, instead of drawing that same piece, grab that same piece of cardboard, trace it, and cut it out. I'm gonna go ahead and finish cutting out the rest of my mask and making sure everything is symmetrical. And just like that, it's time to hot glue. So go ahead and head over to the hot glue gun station, lay out your pieces one more time, making sure everything is symmetrical and just the way you like it. And just like the glue bottles, dot, dot, not a lot. You really don't need a lot of hot glue for this project. The only thing I will make sure is that your horns are nicely secure behind the head. And it's painting time! Now you can totally skip this step, but I always like to prime my cardboard. I believe that painting it white makes the colors just so much more brighter and vivid. A painting tip I like to tell my students is make sure they have a bowl of water when they're painting. I am using a very heavy, thick acrylic paint, so by having the water, they simply just dip their paintbrush into the water and it helps spread out the acrylic paint a little bit more. Before you add your color, use a pencil to map out your different sections. Remember, these masks are known to be symmetrical, so whatever you do to one side, make sure you do it to the other. Once you have mapped out your Viagante mask, go ahead and start adding your color. Viagante masks are known for their polka dots, lines, patterns, and their symmetrical designs. So I'm going to go in with this little tiny round sponge to create my polka dots and add some line patterns to my mask. The possibilities here are endless. Get creative and have fun with it. Take your time. Just like that, my art teacher friends, you now have your own unique, creative, Viagante Puerto Rican-inspired mask. If you decide to do this project, be sure to tag me on Instagram or Twitter. I cannot wait to see what you and your students create. And until our next sculpture project, Miss Cassiano out.